Another officer with a shield arrived at 12:03. Another with a shield arrived a few minutes later. 30 minutes before they breach it, the guy in charge is wondering, could he be shot through a window? Finally, at 12:46, he told the tactical team members to breach the door when ready. I mean, look, you can see in this picture, by the way, it is possible that I am misinterpreting this, but what it looks like for that ballistic shield, it looks like it's the type that has a firing port in it, and it looks like that guy has got a rifle or a shotgun pointed through it. Like this footage is revealing what they had. They keep saying that they were totally outgunned. All of the evidence proves that it's not the case. And I'll remind you that they are working as hard as I've ever seen cops work to stop more of the body cam footage from being revealed. What must be on that footage for them to be fighting this hard? What was said? What will they have? What more is there left for Arredondo to have said that could be proven to be false? And maybe we'll find out. Maybe we'll find out. Go to this tweet, by the way, you'll see it's shields and rifles and all of that stuff. And look, we feel a need because obviously we as a network have for a very long time been very critical of the cops because the cops have provided a never ending supply of reasons to be critical of them. So when cops fail, we have to talk about that. When cops lie, we definitely have to talk about that. But I will say again what I've said basically every time that we've talked about Uvalde. I kind of hate that we need to check all of this stuff, Alonzo, because it makes it seem as if this is the relevant variable. And I don't believe that it is. And to prove that, consider an experiment. What if they'd had the key? Or what if the cops had been braver? Or what if the cops had moved in faster? What if the cops had done right? All of the things that we've identified that they did wrong. Would that have solved all of the problems? No. Maybe some lives would have been saved. That's good. I would have loved that. But a bunch of people would have died in the first few moments. Because what let that happen isn't that cops weren't brave enough. It's that a deranged 18-year-old was able to get an assault rifle. That was the problem. You might be able to, we could do little tweaks around the edges that get cops to rush in the door faster or whatever. Maybe have more AR-15s waiting to go for them. That helps in response to the true problem, which is that people can get these incredibly deadly guns and kill a bunch of people almost instantaneously. And because we're focusing so much on the cops, you'll notice in Texas, they're not considering changing anything having to do with assault rifles. Nationally, we're considering like a little bit around background checks, a little bit around red flags, nothing about raising the age to get an AR-15 or anything like that. And so this looks really bad for Uvalde. This has been a terrible PR situation for them. But for the right, this is basically played out how they would have wished, because nothing fundamentally is going to change. It is going to be just as easy for the next potential mass shooter to go and get a couple of AR-15s and kill a bunch of people. And we're going to be left like with our fingers crossed, hoping that the cops Rambo through the door in a couple of minutes so that only 5 or 10 kids die next time. That's my fear, Alonzo.
Well, I don't blame the right, because the right wing is saying this. They stated their position and they haven't changed, that they're okay with these weapons. And by the way, there have been many gun experts and people who know these things who have said AR-15 and assault and military style weapons are made to kill people, okay? They're not made to hunt. They're not made, you know, I used to do a joke that you know, these things shoot through bulletproof vests. If you're hunting and you see a deer with a bulletproof vest, you should probably leave him alone. Okay, that'd be one that he knows somebody, right? It's sad. I'm not joking about this murder, but I joke about the ridiculousness of this theory. No, this is on the Democratic Party. This is on the Democratic leadership who doesn't, you talk about being cowards. They don't have the courage to pass an executive order. They don't have the courage to stop these weapons. You know, I happened to be in London when this happened. If you see the foreign press, they're totally baffled as to how many school shootings we have and how easy it is to buy the weapons. They're absolutely baffled. They're like, what are you people doing? What is wrong with you? So I don't blame the right wing. This is on the Democratic Party for not doing anything. You talk about weakened laws. New York passed a law against body armor Two words were not in the law, body and armor. The body armor used in the Buffalo shooting is still legal after this law has been passed. So how many toothless, it's all just talk, you know? How many toothless laws are you gonna pass? How many times are you gonna suggest, listen, Bill Clinton banned assault weapons, okay? Newt Gingrich was mad about it. They were all mad about it. You know what happened? There were fewer mass shootings. That's what happened. That was the result. There were fewer mass shootings. I'm not anti-gun. I'm anti-stupid. We are stupid, okay? Guns in responsible hands, educated hands, guns are okay. People hunt, people target, shoot, whatever. All of that's fine. These weapons are designed, have been designed for the military and to kill people. That is the purpose of these weapons. When does it stop? It doesn't. It doesn't.
100%. Yeah. Yeah. It is indisputable that some people clearly shouldn't have guns. This is one of the many indisputable things that they refuse to actually acknowledge. Like, their response will always be, well, okay, no, but like if good people also have guns, that's fine. Okay, well, in that case, go into a jail and give all the prisoners guns. I mean, what's the difference? The guards have guns, so it equals out. Like, none of this makes any sense. It's absolute madness. And it's fundamental madness because they don't care. As Alonzo said earlier, we made the decision that, you know, kids being gunned down, their bodies being blown apart, doesn't matter. Now, most Americans don't agree with that, but unfortunately, a critical mass of those in elected office do. Lauren Boebert, Greg Abbott, these people don't care. They just don't care, or at least they don't care enough to do literally anything about it. If it was of no cost to them or the industries that they defend or their electoral prospects or the culture war they're engaged in, then sure, maybe they'd prefer in that hypothetical world where it costs them nothing, fewer kids being blown to bits. But in a world where there is a cost, they just don't care. It doesn't matter. For more political news, breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.